What's up everyone, if you are new, my name is Satyam Kashyap. Today I will talk about renal calculi or kidney stone. Renal calculi या फिर kidney stone होते हैं वो mainly composed होते हैं calcium oxalate के या फिर calcium phosphate के या फिर दोनों के हो सकते हैं. Phosphate stones जब present होते हैं जब कोई infection present होता है और uric acid stone और cystine stones mainly less frequently present होते हैं. Now, etiology. Certain specific factors are known to play a role in particular variety of formation of kidney stone, such as hyperparathyroidism, cystinuria and oxaluria, gout and infection of renal tract. Cystinuria means high concentration of amino acid cystine in the urine, and oxaluria means excess of oxalic acid in urine. The reason for formation of oxalate, common oxalate or mixed oxalate and phosphate formation is still obscure, not well known. The concentration of the urine as in hot climates, recumbency position means lying position or prolonged high intake of high level of calcium are predisposing factor but not explain the individual predisposition to the stone formation. Many stone formers have idiopathic hypercalciuria with normal serum calcium or they excrete an excessive amount of oxalate, factors which are likely to favor precipitation in pelvis or tubule. Hyperparathyroidism is unsuspected in the patient with recurrent renal calculi and this type of patient should have repeated measurement of the serum calcium level. If this is above 10.5%, the test may be significant. In urinary congenital oxaluria, the urine oxalate amount is 100 to 400 mg, while the normal is 26 mg. This error is due to inborn metabolism of glycine, that is amino acid, is diverted into the formation of phosphate. The latter, which is oxalate, is deposited into the various tissues of the body, including kidney. Now the kidney becomes grossly disorganized and contracted. Death takes place in the children because of uremia. Now the symptoms and diagnosis. The renal calculi may cause symptoms due to hemorrhage, obstruction, ulceration, and infection. Stones in the kidney may produce severe pain or loin pain in the region of kidney when pushing. Stones in the ureter may cause renal pain and hydronephrosis. Hydronephrosis is a condition in easy language characterized by excess of urine in the kidney due to backup of urine. There may be infection and urinary stricture, means narrowing of the ureter. And the diagnosis is usually made by X-ray demonstration except in the case of urate stones which are generally translucent. Crystals in the urine deposit may be of significant value especially in the ureteric colic which are very small oxalate stones. Now the treatment. The stone at the lower end of the ureter requires a surgical intervention. The risk of obstruction and infection makes it desirable to remove renal calculi unless these are small and asymptomatic and very large and bilateral. The latter means large and bilateral may cause considerable impairment of the kidney which may remain static for many years. The unilateral staghorn calculus means that covers the part or part of the renal pelvis with a badly damaged infected kidney calls for nephrectomy. The possibility of specific metabolic disorders such as hyperparathyroidism requires a thorough investigation in all cases and appropriate surgical treatment when indicated. So this was about kidney stone, etiology, diagnosis and symptoms and treatment. So don't forget to hit the like button and friends, if you are new, subscribe the channel and be the part of the YouTube family. Good day.